Hello, my dear viewers! This is Mega88-1000 again, and a warm welcome to another info video, and to you. As there is the interview on the Digimon Partners site with the two designers responsible for the new SH figure arts Dukemon Rebirth of Holy Knight figure and the new Digimon Tamers D-Arcs, which one of my last info videos was about those infos. There was also a similar interview with a designer who is responsible for the development of the Digimon Figure-riseStandard model kit figure series, and that's what this video is about now. And because it goes so well with it, also with this video you will get a first short info about the announcement and official promotion update of the latest upcoming announced release of the Digimon Figure-riseStandard Amplified series. Because quite some time ago, for now, also an Alphamon Amplified model kit got announced for the series. But first to the content of the interview, which has the following headline. Interview with the person in charge of the Figure-riseStandard model kit series. Like you can see, including this title image below, with the Figure-riseStandard anime design, WarGreymon, Metal Garurumon and Magnamon model kit figures. At the top we have the short advertisement again with the following introduction. The plastic model kit Figure-riseStandard Amplified Beelzebumon was released on Saturday, 29th January. We spoke to the person in charge about the Figure-riseStandard series, with the release of the Figure-riseStandard Magnamon coming in February, about a series appeal and commitment. Of course, the given dates are the Japanese dates, and you will already notice that I will interrupt the said things in the interview from time to time and comment on them with my own thoughts and words if I find it necessary to do. Yeah, you know this. In this interview too, the Digimon partner staff conducts the interview again. And the staff, which I will also call on DP staff here again. And so the DP staff interviews the responsible person, who is referred to as the development manager, more precisely below, person in charge of plastic model development of the Bandai Spirits Hobby Division Inc. And I also will have linked the Digimon partner site with this interview in the video's description down below. So DP staff starts the interview again with the same funny reverence as in the last interview, or like he did in the last interview. Digimon lover in his 30s, and first asked the development manager to tell something about the Digimon plastic model kit series. The development manager answers, so I am in charge of planning and development. Together with the team in charge of design, I develop products with input from A.S. Maria and other Digimon designers. DP staff asks the next question. I have heard that A.S. Maria even creates three-dimensional drawings when he designs his characters. Development manager replies, A.S. Maria has been a great help to us, especially when we started planning the Amplified Digimon kits. When I talk to A.S. Maria, we come up each other with ideas for gimmicks and modeling. He has also been very helpful to us sometimes, making the three-dimensional plans for the plastic models as they should be. He was also very helpful. And sometimes correcting or adding things with red for the blends we made. He has a deep knowledge about plastic models and sometimes gives us ideas for gimmicks and extensions for plastic models, which is really reassuring. And you hope you can remember that A.S. Mariah is a Bandai designer, also known as A.C. Mariah, and also shortened as ATSMA. I told you about it in one of my info videos before, maybe you remember. Among other things, he used to draw some illustrations for various Digimon cards, and also did design for games. He was specially commissioned to design Metal Garurumon X, and was later responsible for designing more than 20 other X-antibody Digimon for Digimon Chronicle, the storyline of a kinda manga-type series that accompanied the VPET Pendulum X series. His X-antibody Digimon designs are notable for their incorporation of heavy armor and green light-emitting objects. Nicknamed as Asma Green by Kenji Watanabe. Just again for better understanding who he is, and on with the interview. So, the DP staff continues to ask questions. So you are an indispensable part of the production process. So, how did you come to handle Digimon as part of the Figure-riseStandard series? And the development manager replies again, first of all, I was a child who loved Digimon. By having various Digimon experiences with Digimon from LCD Toy and the Digimon anime. When Digimon Adventure aired, I was absorbed in watching TV as if I was one of the chosen children, and it was probably significant that I was the same age as Takeshi Kido. Even after I became an adult, my thoughts remained the same, and I was thinking that one day I would like to be involved in developing Digimon-related items. But the perfect timing was the 20th anniversary of Digimon Adventure, and there were not many new Digimon figure products or moveable figure products. So I wondered if I could develop this as a moveable plastic model. We consulted with the company and we were able to develop the products. We had experience of releasing a kit called Digimon Reboot in the past, and we worked together with Toei Animation and Plex to commercialize it. Excuse me, please. I mean, there's really not much to add about this. It's very, very interesting to read such details again, to get knowledge of such details. I think that's very interesting. And yeah, to hear such details from the person which is responsible himself, and I think I share exactly the same feelings with him, except that I, unfortunately can't participate to design Digimon figures myself. But here we have another designer who is still a fan himself, and I would say again, as I did last time, that this is probably the best requirement for us fans to get the best products when they coming from the thoughts and hands of designers who are still fans themselves. Or what do you think? Then we have the following subtitle. Arranged and sculpted to respect the original work. Below we have these two images of Amplified Wargreymon and Omegamon 1. Model kit figures, as you can see. After that, moving on to the following. DP staff. Initially, WarCraymon and OmegaMon were released at first. Why did you decide to include them in the lineup as Amplified? Development Manager. The Digimon series has many fascinating characters, and the timing of this product's release coincided with the 20th anniversary of Digimon Adventure, so the popular WarCraymon from Digimon Adventure and Digimon Adventure Bokura no War game. It was soon decided to commercialize, produce the popular WarCraymon from Digimon Adventure and the popular OmegaMon from Digimon Adventure Our War game. When it was decided to sculpt WarCraymon as a plastic model, we were asked if we could add some original fun that only a plastic model or model kit could offer. So by adding the extensibility and arrangement designs that are possible only with original plastic model kit figures, we added gimmicks for reproducing scenes from the anime and gimmicks that can be enjoyed as a plastic model kit series figure. Well, nice. It's great to find out about such details again, because I especially didn't really knew until now, as I've mentioned several times before, where and how to classify or to put the Amplified Digimon designs in general. WarCraymon Amplified reminded me a lot of the or on the design of WarCraymon X Antibody, and still does, in a more modified form of course, but by stating we added gimmicks to reproduce scenes from the movie and gimmicks that can be enjoyed as a plastic model kit series, they probably aim to, on one hand, respect and reproduce the original character design's look, but also a very modified design. On the other hand, also to serve the other Bandai model kit sections, to also create a bit of this popular mecha model kit feeling from example Gundams or such as that you know from such other model kits, robots and stuff and like that. Yeah, and so to be able to connect it with the Digimon designs, because most Amplified Digimon model kits looking still a lot more mechanical than their original X-Antibody designs do look. In shorter words, I think Bandai just wanted to serve both worlds and connected kinda something, and most importantly appeal to people who are fans of both franchises. Yes! Something like that I would filter out here from these statements and texts. I won't say anything more about the fact that the decision was made for WarCraymon and OmegaMon either by the development manager nor his designer team, but Bandai, because it's always WarCraymon and OmegaMon. Yeah, you know how things are going. You know it. Though the first Amplified OmegaMon was only a very slightly modified repaint of the 2010 reboot OmegaMon model kit figure, also the development manager did mention it here, and so for me it was only a fake Amplified OmegaMon kit, because not comparable with the other newly or the later real Amplified Digimon kits designs. I had already informed you about this topic before, I just wanted to mention it again, because as you can see, further reboot Digimon kits were planned back then, but they never seen and released because reboot OmegaMon kit doesn't sold so well, I think. But you can clearly see this mecha gimmick on these designs and even more on them than it is in contrary with the real Amplified Digimon kits now. These blend designs of those are more mecha, Gundam-like, and looking more or less like their real Digimon character designs. And you also can see this on this first fake Amplified Omegamon kit. Now with the real Amplified Digimon kits, as mentioned by the designer himself, it's the other way around. But first Amplified Omegamon figure, it's overall the reused mold of the reboot Omegamon kit. To compensate this thing with the first fake Amplified Omegamon, they made a complete new 2.0 Amplified Omegamon figure later, which you can rather call the real Amplified Omegamon now. DP Steph, currently there are two axes of development, Figure-riseStandard Amplified and Figure-riseStandard Anime Design, but can you tell us again about the characteristics of each? Development Manager. Amplified, the team of the Amplified series is respecting the original story and amplifying the appeal of the characters. We aim to reproduce the charm of the original characters and their movements in the play while adding original model kit arrangements to make them interesting as model kits. The standard anime series began with the Figure-riseStandard WarCraymon in October 2021 under the theme of reproducing the appealing characters who were active in the anime of that time. The first time this happened was in 1983. Well, yeah. The silhouette of the anime design is kept in mind by ensuring a range of motion that can reproduce the motions of the movie. Yes, folks, the text does say 1983, as you can see, but I'm pretty sure that this was a mistake and they meant at least 1993. Yeah, about that I'm pretty sure. But this further statement from the designer of what the Amplified series is aiming for, with reproducing original character designs while adding original plastic model kit arrangements or model kit designs to make them interesting as model kits, I seeing as a confirmation for my thoughts I did just before when I said that with the Amplified series they want to appeal to the mecha world and fans of Gundam etc, as well as to Digimon fans, for people who are fans of both franchises. Or what do you mean? But this statement again, with make them interesting as plastic models or model kits, makes it pretty much clear. Below this we have again this next subtitle: quadrupedal with many difficulties. TP Steph asked a question about, have there been any model kits so far that have been difficult to develop? And we also have these two images of Figure-riseStandard anime Metal Garurumon and one of Amplified Metal Garurumon, as you can see. Development Manager. One product that has been more of a challenge than a hardship is Metal Garurumon, both in the Amplified and the Standard anime series. For the bipedal ones, of course, it depends on the design, but the moveable gimmicks for the arms and legs are not that difficult. However, for quadrupedal figures, in order to make them crawl or stand on the ground in a pose that looks good without compromising the design, a different range of movement has to be considered than in contrary for bipedal figures. In the case of Amplified's Metal Garurumon, we have included various special moveable gimmicks to solve this problem. For example, when the body is turned to the side, the shoulder axes are altered so that they move back and forth to make the gap less noticeable. While the standard series, which Repute uses design, the design of the anime, has a gimmick to lower the shoulder axis on one step so that the figure can crawl or stand on its hind legs. Such innovations were necessary, so I have a particular attachment to this character. Or this figures. Also very interesting to experience that again. And you can see that they really think about developing and delivering good products, which are not just run-of-the-mill products, I would say. I only know a bit about this, as I still haven't built up my first two amplified model kits. So, I haven't have a direct experience with them yet, but they look good to me. Yeah. I just can't decide if I give them a better custom paint job or just assemble them like they are. I really don't feel like painting them, but I also know that if I just put them together like they are, I won't like the general plastic look of them. So I will ending up painting them anyway. A vicious circle, really. Yeah, just wanted to mention that in case you are wondering where all their reviews are. So that will take a good while more. And I better continue with the interview. DP Steph, the Figure-riseStandard Amplified Beelzebumon has a much cooler design. Can you tell us about behind the scenes of the development of or about this one? Below that we have the three images of Amplified Beelzebumon and how the DP guy just dismisses Metal Garurumon as an more not as cool design in compared to Amplified Beelzebumon's cool design. Isn't that nice though? No, that's not nice. Development manager. Actually, it was a character that we had been consulting with various people, including A.S. Mariah, about for several years. So we had a lot of feelings about it. In particular, if we arranged the jacket of Beelzebumon in such a way that it looked like a mecha, it would become something else. So we have arranged it in such a way that if you look closely, you can see that the insides of the suit is designed to look like a plastic model, while retaining the attractive design features of Beelzebumon. Another important point as an original plastic model arrangement is the expandability and playability as a plastic model due to the 3.1mm and 5mm holes that have been meticulously provided all over the body. Furthermore, the two shotguns Barangena are mounted on his back and legs, but to pose him with the shotguns Barangena on his back and legs, simply moving his arms is not enough to make him look good. We took various factors into consideration while developing the figure, so that the characterization of the figure would not get lost, while at the same time allowing a good range of movement and allowing the Barangena on the back and legs to be taken out, or the mentioned shotguns. And yeah, it sounds as if they had really thought about the design of this figure also very well, so that you can see the more mecha or amplified design for the Beelzebumon amplified model kit on one hand, while on the other hand you can still notice Beelzebumon's typical normal character design also very well. I think it's fair to say that the designers have managed this balancing act very good, but also I still stick to my opinion, as I already said about his promotion update. I think that the normal Beelzebumon character was just a bit the wrong choice, because Beelzebumon isn't just too humanoid character design in a leather biker outfit, and in my opinion has therefore too less details to be able to amplify on him. Yeah, and I think if they had gone for Beelzebumon blaster mode, at least they could have amplified his big laser weapon a bit more. But with the normal character design of Beelzebumon, there are just too few details to go well with the amplified design, as I said about the promotion back then. Like I said before, slightly wrong and weird choice for the amplified series, considering how many other Digimon are there which already have a more mechanical look with their general design, and just all would have suited better than in contrary Beelzebumon for doing this. And I don't want to talk it bad either, but somehow it also seems kinda a bit forced for Beelzebumon, as if Bandai's bosses had decided it has to be Beelzebumon because for being a popular character with sales and profit guarantee. So designer team, make your thoughts about so that this becomes amplified. Yeah, you know how things are going. It would have been more suitable, in my opinion, for the normal Figure-riseStandard anime model kit series, because there will be this Tamers Dukemon anime style model kit. Yeah, and in any case, why not bringing Beelzebumon under this series? Yeah. But we're going on with the interview, and so the DP staff answers on this statement the following. You have thought through all the details that are difficult to see just by looking at the finished product. What do you think of the Figure-riseStandard Magnamon? I think this is a product that had high expectations for the lineup. Development Manager. The standard Magnamon from Digimon Adventure 02 was selected as the third standard anime design product, as there were many requests from fans for a commercialization of this product. When we announced that they're making it, or the first teaser, we received a great response and once again felt the high popularity of Magnamon. Well, finally they did. Because our design studios did it before, yeah. So much about that, but yeah. As a move-able plastic model kit, the Magnamon has a large armor on his shoulders, which made it difficult to pose it naturally. This time, by providing 2 points of movement in the shoulder armor, we have made it possible to take poses such as Magnum Punch and other poses from the movie or anime in a natural way. I don't know if the designer is referring to Bandai's old Magnamon model kit figure for kids, because this had a very limited articulation. When he was saying it's difficult to pose it due to the large shoulder armor, or if he only want to mention this in general for giving us an idea of the difficulty of implementation to reach a good poseability. We already know more details about this from his promotion update below, that we have the following subtitle. Happy with the reaction of Digimon fans. Yeah, of course I have to say something more about the Magnamon model kit, which I have already mentioned several times in various videos before, which relates to the pure optics. I stick to the fact that I think it's the kinda wrong chosen type of figure series for especially Magnamon. Since it is in quotation marks only a model kit with the typical simpler pale plastic look and therefore cannot represent Magnamon's true character design or the radiant gold Magnamon correctly, with having this rather plastic look design for being a model kit. Yeah. Again, I want to tell my thoughts about this. And yeah, so the design studios did a better job with Digimazing Magnamon's bright gold plated Magnamon for a better depiction and representation of the character Magnamon. Yeah, and also KH Zone with the shaded metallic gold paint job for their Magnamon did it better. Even if the official model kit has injection gold colored molded plastic for his armor parts, with the simpler plastic look for the Magnamon kit, again, still cannot compete visually with the two unofficial design studio figures, only if you give it a better custom paint job. And I think not much fans all want to do this or be able to do this. Of course, the model kit is a lot cheaper in price, yes, but I would have preferred to see a first new figure for Magnamon at today's level rather as a full figure arts Magnamon figure. You know, as we found out in the last interview, they actually want to start big again with the figure arts Digimon figure series. Wouldn't Magnamon have been perfect for that? The design studio's done it, but Bandai brings Magnamon only, in quotation marks again, as a model kit. Yeah, it's kinda funny. Though, on one hand, it's very nice that the fans' wishes for an official Magnamon figure have been finally heard now, but the fact that it is just a model kit is simply not the best thing from the visual point of view, as I said. But I am more relaxed about that now, because the latest development of things showing that since Magnamon officially comes only as a model kit, it doesn't necessarily mean that Magnamon any longer being considered as a brand new better SH Figure Arts Magnamon figure. My opinion on that was different before. Yes, that's true, but with Figure-riseStandard Tubemon anime style model kit and the additional Figure Arts Tubemon rebirth of Holy Knight figure, instead of a repaint premium color edition with cloth cape of the former D-Arts Tubemon, Bandai definitely taught us a better with that surprise. Because many had thought before, while there is a new Tubemon model kit figure, it will take the slot for an additional Figure Arts Tubemon premium color edition. But surprise, we were wrong about this, so I think nothing is lost for Figure Arts Magnamon. Let's just let ourselves be surprised, and since the Magnamon model kit has already generated very positive reactions from the fans, a Figure Arts Magnamon doesn't seem as unthinkable as we all previously did expected it. Also, in case you are wondering, like I did before, that the official Magnamon got a five-finger fist molded, though Magnamon is more familiar known with a three-finger hand, at least in my imagination, and maybe in yours too. So because of this, I maybe made some fun about this fact in one of my videos already, and if this is the case, yeah, well, I have to correct it. Because the thing is, now that I watched a review about a new Magnamon model kit figure, and the reviewer mentioned that the five finger fist is right done for the Magnamon model kit, since Magnamon actually has a five-finger hand in the anime as well. Yeah, though I actually don't remember that. Yeah. And he mentioned on that only the Royal Knight Magnamon would has the three-finger hand. That would be the official explanation and my own correction if I had already made fun of it at all. But well, since the official Magnamon model kit is exactly based on the anime design, the five-finger fist is therefore also correct. If you know that, and the YouTuber should be right about the statement. So in this case, right things should remain right as well, no doubts about this. So I was completely wrong then, also because of that not knowing it better, but for my defense, however, I have to say that Bandai's previous old Magnamon figures, no matter what figure series, only ever got a three-finger hand designed, but never a five-finger hand, and these old action figures are actually also rather made and based on the anime to make toys of them. In addition, the Bandai character design also has only a three-finger hand, so I memorized this design rather than the right one over the years. Yeah. Additionally, the new design studio's Magnamon figures also all got in three-finger hand molded, so I automatically considered the first time five-finger hand for a first brand new official Magnamon figure as wrong. Also ask another fan and he also replied that he don't remembers on any Magnamon design with five fingers. Yeah! But again, if the statement from the YouTuber is correct, the Magnamon in the anime has five finger and the Royal Knight Magnamon has a three finger hand. Yes! So much for that, and on with the interview. And so the DP staff asks, how do you feel about it as a plastic model product in terms of fan reactions, etc? Development manager, some people painted Walkraymon in black Walkraymon colors on the day of release or converted Omegamon to merciful mode. Though they can play with Digimon plastic models in this way, we are happy that we are able to do this. We receive many comments and messages about the Digimon series of plastic models, including product questionnaires, and we read through all of them. We take even the most several opinions to heart and try our best to reflect them in our products. We would be very grateful if the fans could give us their comments on what you like about our products and what you don't like about them. Yeah, these statements are blatant and that they read all the reviews and take them to heart in order to meet the wishes of the fans sounding great. But I have to mention this again, if that's the case, where was that taken to heart thing for Figure Arts Magnamon back then? Because it was always very high on top of these fan polls, but that's probably more down to the Bandai's boardroom, because they make the final decisions if the designers are allowed to implement their suggestions or not. Or their wishes. And we know that the executive floor is always on the safe side and prefers always to bring the same popular characters in order to have a sales guarantee, instead of venturing into other new realms, as in contrary design studios doing. Well, let us be surprised for the future, as I said. DP Steph, what are your future plans and ambitions? Development Manager. Figure-riseStandard Digimon. Starting with the June release of the Figure-riseStandard Digimon, the standard range will continue to be developed. Or the line. Of course, we are also planning the amplified line of products after Beelzebumon, so please look forward to further news on that too. We will continue to plan and develop both series in a positive manner so as not to disappoint our fans, so please support both series. DP Steff, I'm looking forward to it, thank you. Yeah, also interesting to find out again such details, so it continues with both Digimon model kit series, very nice to hear, or what do you think? And the next official promotion for another amplified model kit figure has already been made official with amplified Alphamon. I actually wanted to include the details about this here as well, but since this got too long already, yeah, it got much long. I think it would be better if I'm making a shorter extra info update video about this topic as usual. But in any case, they've been paying a lot of attention to Alphamon lately, maybe a bit too much, don't you think too? I mean, we got the great Bandai Machinations half repaint with the awesome upgrades, SH Figure Arts Alphamon Uryuken Premium Color Edition, Shodo Alphamon NX Edge Style Alphamon Repaint Release Special Color, and now Alphamon Amplified Model Kit. Yeah, make your own thoughts about this. Anyway, at this point I hope that the video about the interview was a bit interesting for you again. I'm done with it. If you liked it, so please leave me a thumbs up for it, and of course you can also subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching and for your attention. Until the next video, take care guys, your Mega88 1000.